Hey, Freedom Kids, I miss you and all your little pretty faces. I'm so proud of you guys for watching us online. That shows a great commitment and devotion to God. It really does. And all of you who participated last week, you turned in your answers. Guess what? We got them waiting for you. Again, this week, I want you to do the same thing. And for those who didn't do it last week, you have an opportunity to do it this week. Because we got the rewards for you. And it's not just about these rewards now. It's about your relationship with God. So keep that in mind. And don't forget to send your answers to kids@myfreedomdfw.com. Love you.
Hey guys, welcome to Freedom Kids Praise and Worship. I'm Alexia, this is Michaela, and that's Mackenzie. We are so glad to have you all watching online today. And let's get hyped up for praise and worship. Woo!
Let's go. I don't know what you're going through, but we stopped by to tell you that what's in front of you is bigger than what's behind you. Your destiny, your promise, your future. You might as well shout before you get it, because God sent me here to tell you that what he has for you is gonna be big.
I believe
that it's my season.
That it's my season.
You ought to declare that over your own life. Say, I believe.
I believe.
That it's my time.
That it's my time.
It's my time.
It's my time.
And I can feel it.
And I can feel it.
Say, breakthroughs in the room.
Breakthroughs in the room.
It's yours if you want it. Anticipating.
Anticipating.
God's getting ready to move.
God's getting ready to move.
Listen, you ought to declare this over your own life. Say it.
For I know
God,
my God,
he's working,
a miracle
just for me.
Just for me.
And it's gonna be.
And it's gonna be. Big,
hey!
Big.
Listen, I don't know about you, but I'm excited about my future. Why? It's gonna be big. Shouting into my promise. Why? God's gonna.
It may not have looked like a promising future after Joseph was rejected by his own brothers and sold into slavery. But God had a plan that included mercy and a mighty deliverance. He raised Joseph out of slavery and into a powerful position over all of Egypt, and revealed to him things that no one else knew. When famine came, Joseph was prepared, and many lives were saved, including the brothers who had once despised him. With open arms, Joseph received his father Jacob, his brothers, and all their families. They lived happily together in Egypt, enjoying the blessings of God's great deliverance. But time passed, and a new pharaoh rose to power who did not know Joseph or remember how God had delivered them from famine and certain death. Instead, he felt threatened by the people of Israel, who were now growing in numbers and strength. Out of fear and evil in his heart, this new king forced the people of Israel into slavery and did everything he could to stop them from becoming a mighty people. Yet another pharaoh attempted to destroy the people of Israel by demanding that every son born to the Hebrews be killed. "Throw them into the Nile River," he commanded. He would rather murder them than watch them continue to live in the goodness and blessings of God. Little did this king know that he sought to destroy a nation of people God had promised would be great. God was preparing his people for one of the greatest deliverance stories of all time. During the time of Pharaoh's evil order, a Hebrew woman gave birth to a baby boy. She named him Moses. Seeing that he was no ordinary child, and his life was already marked with God's favor and mercy, Moses' mother hid him from Pharaoh's men as long as she could. When she could no longer keep him hidden, she devised a hopeful plan. She built a strong basket and coated it with tar and pitch so that it would float like a tiny little boat. She then placed baby Moses inside, took him down to the Nile River, and hid him in the tall grass along the water's edge. As she watched him drift down the river toward an unknown future, tears filled her eyes. She was sad to let him go, but her hope was in God. Moses' sister Miriam ran along the riverbank, watching the basket as it swiftly drifted downstream. She anxiously looked ahead, hoping for a miracle to save her little brother's life. The basket soon broke away from the bulrushes and plants and came into view of an Egyptian princess and her maidens who were bathing in the river. When the princess noticed the curious basket floating in the water, she sent one of her maidens to fetch it. What a surprise to see such a beautiful child looking up at her. His cries melted her heart. Immediately she recognized it was a Hebrew baby boy. "I will raise him as my own," she said, as she held on to the child protectively. So Moses began a life of privilege and pleasure among the royals in Egypt. But one day he would give it all up to gain a treasure that only God could give.
Just as God had a plan for Joseph's life, he has a plan for Moses' life. This shows God's providence, which is God's guidance, and it also shows his omniscience, which is God's unlimited knowledge. Although we did not know we would be out of school 3 weeks for spring break, God did. Moses was born into slavery and was set for death. During this time, Pharaoh was attempting to destroy all of Israel by killing any newborn baby boy. God's plan for Moses was full of mercy and a mighty deliverance. Moses' mom hid him in a basket for as long as she could. When she could no longer hide him, she trusted God created a basket to put him in to make it safe for him to float down the river. It is God's providence that allowed Moses to be in the hands of Pharaoh's daughter at the river. As you go through this situation and any other situation in life, remember, look for God's providence, his direction, and trust and believe that he knows your needs. Let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for sending our deliverer, Jesus the Messiah. Help us to trust you with our lives for salvation, for protection, and for guidance. As we ask these things in Jesus' name, amen.